really quick and simple game, right? Like, the dice are pretty simple. Yeah, I think you're right. I think you could lock yourself potentially. So one of maybe the most interesting things. So I guess really quick. One thing I'm picking up on as I'm playing is these wild flowers in the garden beds. Looks to be that there's one in each garden bed. There's two in the bottom right. Does that make the bottom right bed easier to complete? I don't know. That's an interesting thought, right? But one thing I'm thinking about is when I use that flower early, it gives me less flexibility to use it in the future. And so if I'm able to sneak by and cover, you know, four pink instead of five pink, is that a better decision to not use it earlier to allow yourself more flexibility later? I think it probably is, because I think that extra flexibility later in the game is going to be less negative points, less unhappy customers. So that's like hypothesis number one. Hypothesis number two, in terms of, you know, a little bit of strategy in Bloom, going for colors or going for garden beds, right? Like, if you theoretically get all five colors, I suppose that would be worth 20 points. Probably impossible to do in 8 turns. If you get four garden beds, that's going to be worth what, 11 plus 7, 18 points. So there's a fair bit, and I think that could be doable in 8 turns to get four garden beds. But interestingly, like, you can't go above four garden beds, so you know, there might be a slight higher points per garden bed versus points per color if you look at it. Because we start with 3 and then we go to 4 and then we go to 5 and then we go to 6. But you know, I'm also kind of curious how many flower colors are per color. So we got, what do we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 for orange. Count of yellow real quick. 14 for yellow. 13 for blue. 13. So they're pretty even across the board, either 13 or 14. So it doesn't seem like there's one color that's better than the other color. Yeah, 13 purple as well. Doesn't seem like there's one color that's better than the other. But I think like choosing when to use that flexible wildflower is really important. Here is where I think there might be a little bit of extra strategy to unpack, okay? If you look at the board when you start out, you have a two group of pink, you have a three group of pink, a four group of pink, a four group of pink, right? Two of orange, three of orange, four of orange, four of orange. So it's like a 2-3-4-4 seems to be the pattern, or there must be some slight differentiate in the other 2-3-4-4, 2-3-4-4. So it looks like I just miscounted. Looks like they're all 2-3-4-4s, and we're gonna have equal flowers per. What am I going at with this? So when you take a two, if you mark the two, if you circle the two flowers, that's being efficient, right? If you somehow circle this blue flower as a part of your purple, as a part of your pink, okay, then you're now leaving a two blue over here and a two blue over here. So now you have two different areas with two blue bouquets next to each other. So that is going to be probably harder for you to achieve than leaving open the three blue and the two blue, all right? Looks like all of these flowers are even next to, like all the groupings look like all the four groupings are next to a wildflower as well. So there's a little bit of flexibility when it comes there. But where I think maybe some of this like advanced strategy kind of starts to come in is making some of those hard decisions to say, actually, this move right here is going to complete a flower bed or two flower beds or a color and a flower bed. And so it's going to boost your points faster than you're going to get those unhappy customers in a one fell swoop, like using a 6 or a 5 or something. So using those high dice to really close big patches. And there might be like points in time where it makes more sense to do that, right? So for example here, are there any spots on this map where I could actually close off like three groups of colors with a six? I don't know if there is, but you know, that would be really interesting find. So anyway, think about that. We're gonna go ahead and just play it for realsies. Don't want to super overanalyze, but I think there's like, you know, it's interesting. Like it feels like it's pretty light. Feels like it's pretty simple. Yet my mind is churning when I'm making decisions because there's so much potential flexibility in the decision. And I think that's why. All right. We got to get a new song too. This one's a downer. There we go. All right.